Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you the initialization of 1D array in C programming. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app TechMS, which is available on Google Play. So friends, here in this video, I am going to discuss with you how you can initialize a 1D array which is available in C. So first I am including a header file, that is #include stdio.h, then int main. So generally we declare an array like this and then we receive elements from user using scanf statement. So now I am going to initialize this array so that programmer can assign some values to the array. So here this statement is known as initialization of array. So this means here I have declared an array and at the time of its declaration I have assigned some values inside this array. So this statement is known as initialization of array. So this array 0 index will be containing 1, 1 index will be containing value 2 and so on. So I have initialized 5 elements because the size of this array is 5. Now, if I want to print all these values on console, then I can apply a for loop and with the help of printf, I can print all these values on console. So now I am executing this code. You can see the output. All 5 values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are displayed on console with the help of this for loop. And I have not received any input from user. So this is because of this initialization. So you can do this in the program wherever you require this initialization if you don't want to receive values from the user. Now here, if I remove this 5, then also this is correct because size of array will be provided by the counting of this values. So here 5 elements are available, that's why size of array will be 5. So again I am executing this code. You can see it is executing properly and all the elements are displayed on console. So this way you can leave blank this size here, but remember that if you remove these initialization and you only write int a and then this subscript or square brackets are empty, then compiler will show an error message. So now again I am executing this code. You can see it is showing an error message that you can read here, array size missing in a. So friends, if you are not initializing any array, then you cannot leave the size blank. It is applicable only in case of initialization. So now if I apply initialization, it will work properly. It is working properly because of this initialization. So here initialization is important because size is not available. Now another thing, size is 10 and I have initialized only 5 elements and then I am printing it 10 times. So 5 elements are available here. So let's see what happens. You can see the output. First 5 elements are displayed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and remaining elements are 0. So you have to remember that whenever you initialize a 1D array, if you provide less element as compared to the size of the array, then remaining blocks will be filled with 0 automatically. They will not receive garbage values. They will be filled automatically with 0. But if I remove these values and if I provide size here and then I execute this program, you can see the output. All garbage values are displayed here. No proper or significant values are displayed. So friends, if we initialize any array, then only remaining blocks which are not filled will be filled by 0 automatically. But if we only declare the array and we just use that declared array, then all the locations will be filled with garbage values. So I hope you have understood the difference. Now one more thing, size of array is 1 and I have initialized 5 elements. So let's see what happens. It is showing warning that size is 1 and we are assigning more values as compared to the size, and it is showing the garbage values also. So friends, you have to ignore, or you have to remove this practice from your code that size is less and you are providing more number of elements, because it provides some warnings in some compiler. It also shows in terms of errors. So if you are providing more elements as compared to the size, then warning or errors may occur in your code. So avoid this practice wherever you are initializing the array. So if you are providing a particular size, then you can initialize it with that size elements, or you can put less number of elements as compared to the size. But putting more number of elements is wrong practice. So now this will work properly. So these are some facts or findings which are available at the time of initialization of array. So I hope you have understood all the facts and things that I have demonstrated. So this is all about initialization of 1D array, which is available in C programming. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel, that is youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool. You can also download my programming app TechImage, which is available on Google Play. Thank you for watching this video.